Hi, this is Paul Kaiser for goodlearning.com. We're going to cover some advanced tilt shift effect techniques here. We're using Photoshop right now, and I'll show these effects done later in probably Paint.net and GIMP. Tilt shift effects take a normal photograph like this and basically try to make it look like a scale model like this. What you see here are the typical effects you get from the tilt shift tutorials you find on the internet. I think we can improve that. First, I'm going to show you how the typical tutorial goes. It's pretty good, but it doesn't work on an image like this, and I'll explain why as we fix it. First, we're going to the quick mask mode. We're going to use the gradient tool, and we're going to use the reflection mode. What we're doing here is selecting the areas that are going to be most focused, and the gradient is going to then let us gradually lose focus as we get closer to or further away from the camera. So we're going to focus most on this vehicle here. I'm going to click and we'll move out here. There we have our mask. Now I'm going to go into regular selection mode, and we're going to use the lens blur filter. And mostly you can change this radius here to exaggerate the effect if you need to, but I think you can see what we're getting here. This area right here looks most focused, and as we get closer or further from that focal point, things get a little blurry. So we hit OK. Now we're going to unselect that. The next step typically is to bump up the saturation, because we're trying to simulate a model. They're going to be painted with some bright paints, pretty shiny, and they're probably not going to be very dirty. So we bump up the saturation. Some tutorials will also have you increase the contrast. But let me tell you the problem with this image, and then we're going to go in and fix it. You look at this building right here at the bottom, it's fairly well in focus because it's about the same focal point as this car. But as we move to the top of the building, it gets blurrier, even though the top of the building is the same distance from the camera as the bottom of the building. So that doesn't look right. And that happens a lot of places in this image with all these vertical expanses. There really should be the same amount of focus, if you will, as the bottom of the image. So we're going to fix that. So we're going to start with the same process. We're going to go into Quick Mask, Gradient Tool, Reflection, pick the spot that we want to be in focus, move the gradient outward. There we go. I'm going to now invert our gradient mask. And what I basically want to do is I want the gradient on this building, I want it to be the same pixel value at the bottom as it is at the top. Same thing, this building, I'm going to pick the bottom pixel value in our mask, and I want it to be the same at the top. Well, I've already saved some selections to make this quicker. First, we're going to pick this building right here. Before I do anything, I need to pick the pixel value. Let's get our eyedropper tool. Go down here and pick a pixel. And now I'm just going to edit fill. I'm going to say foreground color. So now I'm affecting our mask here. I'm going to select none. Let's do this with the next building on the right there. Mid. That's this building right here. Again, we're going to go to the eyedropper tool. I'm going to pick the pixel at the very bottom. I'm going to fill, again, foreground color, Okay, deselect. I'll quickly do this with the next few buildings. Eyedropper, pick our mask color from the bottom. Again, we're picking the mask color, not the color you see back there in the image. We're still working on the mask. Edit, fill, foreground color. We could do Alt backspace, but I'm going to walk you through the steps. Control 9. Let's get these buildings on the left. So, this building here, eyedropper, pick our mask level at the bottom, edit, fill. Foreground color, deselect, select, load. Let's go ahead and do the tree the same way. It's still a vertical area, and I did, after all, work pretty hard on the selection. Pick our bottom color. Fill the selection. Okay. I also think I did even the light poles, or the two bigger light poles anyway. Eyedropper. Let's pick that bottom mask level. And did I do the other light pole? Okay, let's do left back building. Okay, eyedropper. Pick our mask level from the bottom. Fill our selection. And did I get that building in the back? Mid back building. Eyedropper. Mask level at the bottom. Fill. I already did that. Now let's see what results we get. We're going to go and follow the rest of the kind of normal tutorial steps. Go into selection mode instead of mask mode. I need to invert my selection, so I'm blurring outside the selected area. Now I go into the lens blur tool, just as we did before. And I can kind of see the results here. Not too shabby. Make it a little more pronounced. Okay. Unselect. Let's go ahead and do that saturation step. This is all the same stuff. The important change we made was where we selected with our gradient. So there, we bumped up the saturation, and this is our result. So I'm not real happy with this edge here. Probably some more work could be done on that, but you can see there's quite a bit of difference from this to this. Let's make them smaller. You can see them here. Here's our regular version. Here's our improved version. You can see them a lot better on goodlearning.com on the tutorial page. I hope this helped out. Let me know if you have any questions.